Stand by, cassette, stand by.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Prime Minister of Australia, Mr. Harold Holt.
You're a nobody till somebody loves you. You're a nobody till somebody cares. You may be king, you may possess the world and its gold. But gold won't bring you happiness when you're growing old.
This is David Johnson reporting from Portsea. Australia's Prime Minister, Mr. Harold Holt, is missing. At 12 o'clock today, he went for a swim on the ocean side of Portsea Beach.
Officials are still clinging to a hope that Mr. Holt may still be found alive, but they admit their hopes are fading with every minute that goes by.
It was Sunday, December the 17th, 1967. With his country at war in Vietnam, the Australian Prime Minister, Harold Holt, went missing.
The Prime Minister disappears without trace. This is unparalleled in the modern history of Western democracy.
They said it was a case of accidental drowning, an all too common Australian tragedy. But many people remained unconvinced. This is the story of the Prime Minister's secret world in the months before he disappeared. A world of betrayal, political treachery, and mounting physical and mental strain. A world concealed by others and never investigated.
This was softly, softly. The protocol in those days is how far a policeman was allowed to go without stepping on someone's toes.
But the Prime Minister left behind tantalizing clues that day. Clues which challenged the official explanation for his disappearance.
He was a decent man. That's why I feel angry at the unspeakable bastards who were plotting his defeat at the time of his death.